If you grew up thinking love was unsafe and chaotic, take a walk with me. I want you to know that you're not alone in thinking this way. Even for those of you that, when asked, you say your childhood was great. We had dinner every night at 6 p.m. and a roof over our heads. Yet, deep down, you know, you feel it, and it often manifests in your relationships that something wasn't right. It's often difficult to generate the awareness around the circumstances that have left you feeling stuck, or that seem to challenge you the most, leaving you feeling alone, isolated, and frustrated. People have proven to you time and time again that you're on your own to meet your emotional needs. And it's often not until much later in life that you recognize the unhelpful and self-limiting patterns that you've been living in your entire life. And that's because this is your normal. You may never have experienced anything different or had access to it. And of course, your parents and caregivers didn't have it to give because they never experienced it either. Your iOS has been programmed to accept the bare minimum. It's been set up so that it's your job to make sure that you're taking care of others and you have to fix or change them in order to get your needs met. To accept that if you share your innermost thoughts with others, that they're going to use that information against you, forever keeping you at arm's length. It's important to know that this is often subconscious and part of their own conditioned system. This is the normal that they grew up in and recreated. And this is where a lot of us tend to get ourselves in trouble because we end up recreating the same experiences in our own relationships. Because like attracts like, and birds of a feather flock together. And no, this isn't blaming you, but it is an awareness of you. We find the chaos and the lack of safety and security familiar. And like a moth to a flame, we find ourselves attracted, pulled in, and attached. Attached to people, places, situations, and circumstances that disappoint us, hurt us, and leave us feeling diminished and unworthy. And this is where you take a deep breath in through your nose and a long exhale out. It's time to create a practice and a habit of self-soothing. To take the time to get really clear on the areas in which we struggle. And no, this doesn't have to be a deep dive. It's just an opportunity to get to know yourself a little bit better. To know what you like and what you don't like. This is where we start to break free from victim consciousness, that your past doesn't control the potential of your future. You're not locked into this storyline, and it's time for you to pick up the pen. I'm the captain now. And as you begin to create awareness around those past circumstances and situations, you may find yourself saying, I don't want that life. And often, what it really comes down to is you don't want to live the life in the way that your parents and caregivers lived it. And this is where you might say something like, well, I don't need anyone. And it's really that you don't trust yourself enough to know that you would create or co-create something completely different with the skills and knowledge that you have. When you're stuck in a pattern, it doesn't seem like you have a multiverse worth of options. And this is why we go on these walks, because you do have those options. It's time to put what you know into practice and to allow yourself to become the person that you know that you're capable of becoming. To step into the fullness of your frame and allow others to see you in full color.